you guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, I'm Akanksha. I know I have not uploaded for... Why do my videos always start like this? It's not like... I don't plan this. It happens. Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. I know I have not uploaded for like an entire week, but I went on a vacation. I had content to post, but I was like, you know, let's push it. We'll do it some other time. Like I needed that week off for some reason. I don't know why. And anyways, I'm here back again, back to back videos for Tuesday and Friday. So for today's video, you must have read the title already. We are going to talk about the outfits I wore in Goa. So majority of the outfits which I wore in Goa are stitched outfits, which I got them made basically. And a lot of you guys were interested in where I got them, etc. So like might as well make like outfits from scratch videos, because I have 3 to 4 pieces which I got them made. Like, I got them made generally for like regular wear also, but because they were cotton and like, you know, summer was coming, I wanted something and they were nice for the beach as well, so you know, it worked out very perfectly. So getting outfits stitched is not a new thing for me, because I've been getting my clothes stitched ever since like I know about clothes. My mom always did it, got my clothes made so many different times, and I think I just get it from her. But you know, literally when I see people doing outfits from scratch videos and like, you know, get thousands of views, I'm like, I do this every day. I'm like, probably, you know, what I'm doing is content. Like, I need to do this. So anyways, you understood my point. I don't know why I'm blabbering so much. Today's video is about my Goa outfits and me getting them stitched. So let's get started. But before that, hold on. Wait a minute. Look at my makeup. So pretty. I know, thank you. Basically, how I get my western wear stitched is you always need an inspiration picture. So I take my pictures from Pinterest. I just go randomly Google it, or you know, just anytime I find something which I really like, and if it's way too expensive and I cannot afford it, I don't like the certain pattern, but I like the, you know, dress model or something, I save them and see later, you know, in future if I would like, you know, really like them, then I get them stitched. So for every outfit I'm going to show, I have an inspirational picture which I do show the tailor so that they understand how to stitch. You have to be very, very, very specific of what you want, because they are not going to, you know, suggest, and if they suggest also, you might not like it. So you have to be very particular about what you want, because once you go there, you have to even tell them the changes, because sometimes when I show a picture, it's just like a gist of what I want, and there might be changes in that here and there, like maybe I want the hands to be different or the waist to be different or something like that. So you need to be, you know, ready with what those changes are as well, because you have to be like, you go there, you have to have clarity, you cannot confuse them. So the first outfit is this one. This basically I carried it with me, but I never wore it. Raksha ended up wearing this dress. I think this measurements were so perfect for her more than me, and it really, really suited her. So I'll put a picture of her wearing it more than me wearing it, so that you'll, you know, actually understand how it looks. So the inspiration picture I gave for the person, I'll put it on the screen. So I gave a more like A-line, very loose fit type thing for the, you know, the beachy one. So this one looks a little heavier, because that one does not have lining, while this one has. Like, I wanted a cotton lining inside this, because you know, this is not summer material. This I think is georgette or something, and it's not ideal for summer. So this one has a cotton lining inside, which makes it, you know, wearable during summer as well. So this one looks a lot bulkier than the one in the picture, but you know, that's what I wanted as well. So I just added a different type of sleeves to it. By the way, all the fabrics which I'm going to show you, I got it from my friend Navya's business. So my friend Navya like sells fabrics, sarees, etc, etc. So all the fabrics whichever I got to, you know, get this dresses made are from her. So I'll leave a link to her website in the description box if you want to check it out. So basically, this is the outfit, the first top part, and then it has two steps. So these are basically ruffles. There's a cut in between after the waist, and that's it's super, super cute, very nice peach color. So one more thing you need to keep in mind, which I kind of missed out, is that western clothes stitching like, you know, seems to be more usually, because like we get like 500 one top, 1,000 rupees one top, right? But you know, when you get it stitched, it's a lot expensive compared to, you know, normal. Indian, though, we are used to paying 2,000 for stitching, but Western, we're not used to paying 2,000 for stitching. But, you know, all the clothes here are like 1,500 to 2,000 for stitching minimum. So you have to, like, you know, talk to your tailor before about what the costing is. It might vary to, from tailor to tailor anyways. So this material together was around 1,000 rupees and the stitching was around like 1,800 or 2,000. So this totally was 3,000. Like, all these dresses are around 2,500. 2,000 to 3,000, which is a very lot expensive for Western dresses. I completely agree, but we don't have Shein anymore, and like, even when Shein was there, the quality of clothes was not that great. But, you know, seeing now whatever is available in the market and what I really like I'm shopping from Indian labels a lot, and all of them are like, you know, around that range, 2,500 to 3,000 for like any dresses. Quad sets go up to 4,000, so it does come around that, you know, what do you say, price range, which is a lot. I agree, I'm not saying it's cheap, but because I like these fabrics so much, I was like, you know, might as well spend it here because it's kind of the same thing. So instead of, you don't have to do it for regular wear, you can kind of get like a nice dress stitch for occasional purposes. If you're not finding anything and you like a really good fabric, then you can get it done. So in the picture, the dress she wore was like a lot more, the neck was a lot deeper, and then there were like kind of buttons, they were closed buttons, they were not really like a shirt, but they did have like a button type of model, and it was a lot, you know, deeper, which I didn't really want. I wanted something a little more high neck, and she had this tying things as an end, which were like kind of floating around, you can see in the picture. So that's the reason, like, you know, we just put it on the top, so just so it looks similar, but it is not really that similar. So anyways, this is the first dress, and the second one I got, so all these I just wore, and you know, in Goa, and came and my mom washed it, and I didn't have time to, like, you know, iron them or anything, so that's the reason they're very like, what is, crimped. So yeah, this one is the next one. This one is my favorite because of, like, you know, that tie-dye, that very nice salmon pink. Pink is my color, if you don't know. So, and I wanted one nice beach dress. So this is the inspiration picture I got from Pinterest for this. So that one again does not have lining, but this one does. So this one is actually cotton outside, so you can choose not to have the lining inside, but I anyways did take it because sometimes, you know, the material tends to be a little transparent if it's cotton and you're, like, you know, out in the sun, it kind of can be transparent. So that's the reason I got the, you know, entire lining done as well. So that's the picture I showed, and the strap she has are too thin, so I wanted a bigger strap, so I asked him to put a bigger strap, and I didn't want the v-neck to be so much, so I gave him measurements of how exactly I want it to be. The neck kind of went up and I was more comfortable, like, I was not bothered about, you know, what do you say, something showing. I was just more comfortable in the dress, and it's so breezy and so nice. Actually, Raksha and I got these dresses together, so basically we wanted to match and take photos, which did not happen, but we did wear it together and it was super cute. Everybody really liked our dresses and it was really nice. So this also costed around that price range. So there's lining inside, which you have to consider as well. When Navya launched the website, I, like, you know, to show support or something, I placed one order, which was this material. So I took five meters of this, so it was around like 1100 or something, and the stitching charges are again around 1800, and then the lining around everything, it's around 3000. And one thing I make sure, if I get a dress stitched or like a pant stitch or anything, is ask them to put pockets. Like, all of us know, we women don't get pockets. So this one also, you know, so there's one more option for this dress. Like, the back is, you know, a lot deeper. So if you really like that look and you can, you know, kind of wear nipple tape, so that front bra type of thing, and leave it, then you can surely go for the backless one. It'll look a lot cooler. But I, big boobs, cannot wear that. I have to wear a bra. So I kind of went for high neck. So these dresses have pockets on this side and on this side as well. So it fits my phone, it fits my everything. Now this dress does look heavy, and it is heavy as well because it has cotton. Probably if you want like that more falling type of feel to the dress, then you can, instead of cotton, go for crepe lining. But ideally in summer, crepe would again not, like, you know, make you feel a lot hotter, so that's the reason I went with cotton. So it's like a cotton fabric with cotton, what do you say, lining. And one more thing I told him was that my armhole should not be as big as hers, because her armhole went up till her chest, like right above her chest, and I do want to wear my bra, so I don't want the armhole to, it has to be loose but not as low. So while you give your measurements, one thing you do, like if you're regular to the tailor, have to give your exact measurements, like ask them to take your exact measurements inch by inch, like half inch, 1 inch, exact measurements, and then whatever outfits you give, tell them accordingly how much loose you want it to be. So like I gave my exact measurements because I have 4 different outfits to get ready, right? And for each thing there's a different fit. So like one thing I want a tight fit, one thing I want a loose fit. So it's better you give your exact measurements and according to the outfit ask them to make it loose how much ever you want. So for this I asked them to put like at least 3 to 4 inches loose so that it fits very baggy and nice. If you go to a new tailor, then make sure you just give them 1 or 2 outfits and see how they're doing it. You don't want to give them in bulk, because if all of these things go bad, your heart will just break. Like if you know somebody who's got it done there, might maybe like give it, but still it's better to give your measurements first and see how they're stitching, like if you need any changes according to the measurement. So once you get one stitch, you kind of will understand like if you have to tell some changes or not. And moving on to the next outfit is this one, which was a fan favorite. Like I did not post the pictures of the other two, but I did post about this. So many people asked me, where did you get it. So when I saw this, I was like, I need to do something with this. Like I wanted a really cool quad set since a very long time. So basically I got a quad set made, which is very cute. I always wanted to wear something like this in a beachy area and I never got to. And when I saw this material, I was like, yes, I need that. So I had this kaftan in mind, so I just went into Pinterest and I searched for one picture, and this is the picture which I got. So basically that picture has like a bra tube top, a shorts and kaftan, right? So I basically went with, I did not want to go with like a bra top because I personally would not be comfortable. So I got a crop top stitched with sleeves, not like a tube top. So this is a little shorter than a crop top. Like usually crop tops which I wear are like 16 in length, while this one is 15, so just 1 inch, but it does matter when it comes to a crop top. So it just fits like a glove for me, and again this I put like 1 inch strap so that even if I wear a bra, it kind of gets covered with it. Does not matter if it's showing, but I just prefer it that way. So this is the top which I got. I asked them to put it a little loose. So I am heavy chested and I don't like things which like are too tight for me. So you have to be specific about such things. So I asked them to put this like 1 inch more than what they usually would, because I want the fit to be a little looser and so that I'm more comfortable that way, especially because it's a short top. And if it's tight, like once you lift your hands and you get it down, it kind of goes up and it gets stuck there because it's tight. So if it's loose, it kind of is easier to move also, and it's more comfortable also in that way. Then the next one is the shorts. Shorts is literally exactly like how it is in the picture. There's not much difference. I just gave them the length for the shorts and told them how much I wanted and how loose I wanted or how tight I wanted. And again, this also has pockets. I literally would always get my clothes stitched for one reason, is because I can get pockets. Like nobody else gives pockets. I need pockets, and this one has pockets. So this is the shorts. And the last piece is the kaftan. So the kaftan, actually they got it wrong. So I did show them this picture, right? So all these other, like the top and the short have the cotton lining again, because it can be transparent and it's more stiffer this way and more comfortable this way as well. But the kaftan does not have any lining because it's like an overcoat and it has to be very flowy. But once if you put lining, it won't flow. It'll be very stiff and won't look good. So when I showed them the picture of the kaftan, it's like kind of evident that it's straight cut, right? But they did get confused, and then they stitched one like a shrug, which kind of goes like an hourglass thing, which is not a kaftan. Obviously, first of all, I hope this is called kaftan. I'm calling this kaftan because I don't know, it's just in my head. Kaftans are usually closed in the front. You can call this a cover-up basically, something you would wear over a bikini, like a long shrug. So they, this is like a straight cut. Like kaftans are very, very boxy, very loose, and they're very straight. So that's the reason it fits like that. The shoulder is like, you know, near your elbow, and the fit is very loose and looks very nice, basically. But what they did was like they got it right to my measurements and the hourglass figure, which is not really ideal. So they did restitch this again. When they redid this, it bent. It looked so, so beautiful. So this is the kaftan, the shirt, and the top and the short, and this is one of the most favorite outfits which I got stitched. It just looked really well, and especially the place I was staying was so damn beautiful. The pictures came out really, really amazing, and it was very comfortable, like one of the most comfortable outfits I've ever wore. While being very stylish is, I think, this one. Like the neck was proper, the back was proper, the shorts was proper, and I really, really liked how this one turned out. This one is also 190 rupees per meter, so top, short, and this would be around 5 meters, which is again around 1000 rupees, and the stitching is around 2000. So yeah, that's about it. Actually, I don't want to talk about this dress as well. So this also, I got it stitched. So this also, the material is from Navya. Literally all the fabrics I bought in this video are from Navya. So this literally when I saw this material near her, I was like, masaba. I mean, I did just get that vibe. The print is so damn cool, like that brown white. It's a very unique print. It's not like, you know, stripes or flowers or something. This literally gave a very nice luxe feeling to me. I don't know why, and I was like, this is masaba, and I always want, like, I really like masaba's collection, but it's too damn expensive for me to buy. Like, I'm not at a place where I'm spending 20,000 for a quad set, right? So I just, like, you know, saw this material and I was like, I'm getting that done. This was not supposed to be in this video, but, you know, people did ask, and I was like, might as well, you know, include this also in this video so that ek hi baar mein ho jayega and you can get this done. So the stitching of this dress is 1800 and the material is again around 1100 to 1200. So again, 3000. Like I told you, everything is around 2500 to 3000 in this video, but depends on how much your tailor charges. So that can always be different. Definitely check Navya's website out. You'll get multiple fabrics which are so, so beautiful. Like, you need to have the eye for this thing. Like, nobody told me this will look good together. Like, but when you see it, you have to, you know, vision it. But yeah, I think with that, we are done with this video. It's a very different video for my channel because I've never done an outfit from scratch video. I have so many Indian outfits which I got from scratch. Like, I can pull out 10 right now, which I got from my mom's sari, like, in the past 3 or 5 years. My mom always does this. So do let me know if you want to see a Indian version of it, because I know a lot of people would get Indian outfits more than, like, you know, Western outfits made. But I just wanted to, like, you know, make this video so that it's useful for you guys in case you want to know where I got it and what I did. And yeah, I think those were all the outfits which I wore in Goa. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then make sure like and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.